So hello guys, in this video we will solve this problem. So I posted this problem on the community. So I hope all of you try this problem. So now let's start the solution of this problem. So in the problem it is given that in figure a circle is inscribed inside the quarter circle. So this O, B and A point made one quarter circle, and inside this we are inscribing this circle, and the radius of the quarter circle means the point O A B which made the quarter circle. That quarter circle radius is, let's say, 3 centimeter is given in the problem, and QA and PB are tangent to the circle. Now this line and this line is tangent to this inscribed circle. Now we have to find the length of PQ. This we have to find the length of this. So what is the length of this? So this is the problem. So let's start the solution of this. So first we make perpendicular from the center. Now let's assume this is our center, this is the point R, and we make two perpendicular like this, PR and QR, from the center. So now you know that this is our tangent and this is the perpendicular. So this angle is 90 degree, and this is the perpendicular and this is the tangent. So this angle is also 90 degree. And now let's say the angle PRQ, this is phi. This we are let This is the phi angle. So this is the phi angle we are assuming, and R is the radius of the inside circle, like this circle is radius is R. So this length is R and this length is R. We know that if we make perpendicular from center to the tangent, so the length of this is radius. So we know from the cosine rule we can write PQ square is equal to PR square plus QR square minus 2 times PR QR cos phi. So PR is equal to R and QR is also equal to R. So we can write PQ square is equal to R square minus 2 times R square cos phi. So it is equal to 2R square 1 minus cos phi. And we can write 1 minus cos phi is 2 times sine of pi by 2 whole square. So it is equal to 4R square sine of pi by 2 whole square. So from here you can find the value of PQ is equal to 2R times sine of pi by 2. So we have to find in the problem the length of PQ. So for finding the length of PQ, we need what is the value of R and what is the value of sine of pi by 2. So in the rest of the video, we will try to find out the what is the value of R and what is the value of sine of pi by 2. If we find both of these value, we can easily find the value of PQ. So now let's move forward. So let's say this angle is 2 theta. So by the symmetry, we can also say this angle is also 2 theta. So what we are doing, we are assuming the angle PBO is 2 theta. So by symmetry we can also say angle QAO is also 2 theta. So this is we are saying because of the symmetry. Now we know that this angle is 90 degree, and we also know that this angle is also 90 degree, because the PB and QA are the tangent to the inner circle. Now what we can say about the angle, like this inside angle, like the R, P and Q angle, what is this angle and what is this angle? These angles are also equal because the radius is the length of PR and QR is both equal to the radius. So this is the isosceles triangle. So these two angles are also equal, and we know that the angles of a triangle, if we do the sum of all the angles, that is equal to the 180. So if we do the sum of pi plus this angle and this angle, let's say it is phi dash plus phi dash, both angle are equal, so the sum is 180. So the value of theta dash is equal to 180 minus phi by 2. So these inner angle are 90 minus phi by 2. So this inner angle are 90 minus phi by 2. So now let's move forward. So in this figure you can see the O, B, P, Q and A points. If you connect all these points like O, B, P, Q, A, this is one pentagon. So this is one pentagon, and we know that the sum of all the inner angles of the polygon is n minus 2, 180. So if we put n values 5, because it is pentagon, so the inner angle sum is 540. So the angle here plus angle here plus angle here plus angle here plus angle here. So the sum of all these angle is equal to the 540. So we assume that this angle is 2 theta, and this angle is also 2 theta by symmetry. This angle is 90 degree. We know from the problem this is 90 degree. This we assume equal to the 2 theta. And but what is now this angle? This angle, this. So this is 90 plus 90 minus pi by 2, this angle. So this is this angle plus this angle. So the sum of both. So this is 90 plus 5, 90 plus 90 minus pi by 2, and also this. This is also same. This is 90 plus 90 minus pi by 2. So now let's sum all these angles. So now let's sum all these angles. So one is the angle O plus one is the angle B plus one is the angle A plus one is the angle P plus one is the angle Q. The sum of all this is 540. So this is 90 plus the B is 2 theta plus the A is also 2 theta. This is 90 plus 90 minus 5 by 2, and this is also 90 plus 90 minus 5 by 2. And the sum of all is equal to the 540. So how much it is coming? So if you see, like 2 theta plus 2 theta, it is 4 theta minus 5 by 2, and 5 by 2 it is 5, and it is equal to the 90 degree. So from here you can find the value of phi is equal to 4 theta minus 90 degree. So this is the value of phi we are getting. Now let's look at this figure. So in this figure, we if you draw this line like is like that, this outer circle radius line. So this is OC. From the center of the outer circle to the one of the point on the outer circle, so this whole length is equal to the radius of the bigger outer circle. And inner circle radius is this R, and this is the center of the inner circle. So if you draw tangent like here, this tangent, so this radius is also equal to R, and this tangent, like means this perpendicular to this here, this makes is 90 degree, and this length is equal to R, and this perpendicular here, this angle is 90 degree, and this length is also equal to the R. Means if you do draw two perpendicular from the center to the outer circle, so it will come like this. And you can easily say that like the O A and O B and O C, this outer most circle radius we know it is 3 centimeter, like this distance and this whole distance we know it is 3 centimeter because it is the radius of the outer circle. So what we have to find for solving the problem is the radius of the inner circle, this small r values. So what we can do, we can write OR square is equal to OM square plus RM square. We can write from the Pythagoras theorem, this OR square is equal to OM square plus RM square. So it is equal to R square plus R square. So from here you can find the value of OR is equal to root 2 times R. And let's look at this OC length. This OC length from here to here, this OC length. So this is root 2R plus this R. So the OC is equal to the root 2R plus R. So it is root 2 plus 1 times R. And we know the OC length is equal to the 3 centimeter because it is the radius of the outer circle. So 3 is equal to root 2 plus 1 times R. So from here you can find the value of R is equal to 3 divided by root 2 plus 1. So it is 3 multiplied by root 2 minus 1, or it is 3 root 2 minus 3. So this is the radius of the inner circle, like 3 root 2 minus 3. Now let's move forward. Now let's look at this figure. So initially we assume that this whole angle is 2 theta. This whole angle is 2 theta. But if you bisect this angle, bisect this whole angle, so it will become like two parts. Like this angle is theta and this angle is theta because this is also symmetric. So this angle is theta and this angle is theta. So now let's look at this length, like BN length. So what is BN length? We can write this as OB length minus ON length. We know that OB is the radius of the outer circle, which is 3, and ON length, we know that if we draw perpendicular from here, this is the radius of the inner circle. So this we find out like 3 root 2 minus 3. So it is coming like 6 minus 3 root 2. And these angles, like these two angles, are both equal to the theta. So angle NBR and angle PBR both are equal to the theta. We also know this. So this is 90 degree. So from this triangle NRB, NRB, so from this triangle NRB, you look, so you can write tan theta as this length, which is equal to the radius, which is equal to the 3 root 2 minus 3 plus this BN length. So BN length we know like 6 minus 3 root 2. So from here you can write tan theta like 3 root 2 minus 3 and 6 minus 3 root 2. So if you take 3 root 2 common here, so if you take 3 root 2 common here, so it will become root 2 minus 1. And in the numerator you can take 3 common, so it will become root 2 minus 1. So you can see that root 2 minus 1 part is cancelling and it will coming like 1 by root 2. So tan theta value is coming like 1 by root 2. And we know that tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tan theta divided by 1 minus tan of theta whole square. So if we put the value 1 by root 2, it will coming like this. So it is 2 root 2. So tan 2 theta value is 2 root 2. And we know that sine 2 theta divided by cos 2 theta is equal to tan 2 theta. So this value is 2 root 2. And we also know that sine 2 theta whole square plus cos of 2 theta whole square is equal to 1. So if you just put sine 2 theta is equal to 2 root 2 cos 2 theta here in this expression, so it will become like 8 plus 1 times cos of 2 theta whole square is equal to 1. So from here you can get the cos 2 theta value as 1 by 3. And you can get sine 2 theta value as 2 root 2 by 3. So this we are getting. And we know that this relation theta phi is equal to 4 theta minus 90, because our ultimate goal is that we want to find the value of r and sine of phi by 2. So we find the value of r and now we want to find the value of sine of phi by 2. So For that we use this relation, phi is equal to 4 theta minus 90. So here you can see the phi by 2 value. So it is equal to 2 theta minus 45. So if you take sine both side, sine of phi by 2, it's coming like sine of 2 theta minus 45. So you can use this rule, sine a cos b minus cos a sine b. And you can put the value of sine 2 theta like 2 root 2 by 3, and this value is 1 by root 2, and this value is 1 by 3, and this value is 1 by root 2. So it is coming like 2 by 3 minus 1 by 3 root 2. So it is coming like 1 by 3 and 2 root 2 minus 1 by root 2. And you can multiply root 2 above and below. So it is coming like 4 minus root 2 by 6. So this is the value of sine of phi by 2 we are getting. So now we have both the values, and we know from the initial data like the PQ is equal to 2R sine of phi by 2. So now we have the value of R, which is 3 root 2 minus 3, and now we have the value of sine of phi by 2, which is 4 minus root 2 by 6. So we can find the value of this. So here you can take 3 common, and this 2 cancels this 6. So it will become root 2 minus 1 and 4 minus root 2 multiplication. So if you do this multiplication, it is 4 root 2 minus 2 minus 4 plus root 2. So this will come like 5 root 2 minus 6 centimeters. So this is our final answer. So this is the length of PQ. So in this way, you can solve this problem.